works against the fabric of nationhood and national integration. It works against the great project of keeping our people, especially young people like you, united for constructive tasks. In addition to religious fanaticism and communalism, caste divisions, prejudices and hierarchy militate against the idea that we have a secular democratic society in place. While we need to make more rapid progress on the social justice front, we should avoid any activity that divides and confuses people. I have touched on the theme of social inclusiveness to remind you that young people who have stepped out of the academic institution to pursue a variety of careers cannot escape engagement with such social issues, whatever might be their individual inclination, outlook or choice. But in a specific sense, education must be recognized as a sensitive arena for the play of these issues. It's obvious that the foundations for an inclusive society, which presupposes a secular, democratic and progressive outlook, a modern outlook, must be laid in the schools, colleges and universities. We are living in complex and challenging times. There's a need for young people to be realistic, focused, balanced and essentially optimistic through these challenging times. Your education has strengthened your innate capabilities, conferred on you specific and special advantages, given you the opportunity to win prizes, medals and other honors, and prepared you for productive, promising and interesting careers. Some of these careers, I hope, will be in academia. You come from a variety of backgrounds and circumstances, but anyone who goes through a college or university education in India must count himself or herself privileged in a larger social sense. Of course, you deserve all this and more, but do remember that society and its arrangements have made this possible. In a large number of cases, people, that is parents, relatives, teachers and others, have worked hard, saved, sacrificed, used resources intelligently, motivated girls and boys the way Professor Rajan described to me, and gone beyond the call of duty to make your education and intellectual achievements possible. You must commit yourselves morally to doing something for society in return for the great benefit you have received, not just a degree, but also a relevant and valuable modern education representing a lifetime advantage. I think I'd like to conclude on this note. I thank the chairman of the Bannari Amman Institute of Technology for conferring on me the privilege of speaking to you today on this graduation day, and thank all of you for paying attention to what I have said. I wish you hard work, success and every happiness in life.
Now, I invite Padma Bhushan C. N. Ram to present the degree certificates to the graduates of BE degree course in Civil Engineering, Computer Science and Engineering, Electrical and Electronics Engineering, Electronic and Communication Engineering and Mechanical Engineering. Let the candidates be now presented.
Deepak Yamas. Kritika R. Kuppusami M. Lokesh Kumar R. Maga Lakshmi M. Magendran K. Magendran S. Manoj Kumar M. मिलिंद कुमार सी नागराजन एम नंदिनी श्री नाट्टुत्तुरै नल्लमुत्तु पूवेंदन प्रेमा राजकुमार रामनाथन रौनक एन तक सरवणन्यम सिंधल पी स्वर्ण कुमार श्री सुधा पी Surya S. Vignesh S. Vijay Kumar B. Vikram V. Ilamurugan R. गोपालकृष्णन एमपी इलेयराजा के रेणुका देवी एल हरिनारायणी पी तिरुमार And the rest eight candidates received their degrees in absentia.
By Dr. P. Thangaraj, Head of the Department of Computer Science and Engineering of Banariam Institute of Technology, I have the privilege of presenting Aditya A. Abhilesh Kumar K. Abhinaya L. Aishwarya, yes. Arul Swami B. Arun N. Arun Kumar N. Ashok Kumar M. Baby G. Bright Xavier, right. Brinda, yes. Brinda V. Devaraj P. Divya M. Divya V. Divya V. Gayatri D. Gautaman Siyar. Gopalakrishnan G. Gautami D. Gautami R. Janani P. Jeevita C. Jennifer Udayakumari M. Kalanidhi K.S.